she was a special young girl. From her neighbors to her teachers, some labeled her prodigy, others called her a genius. It was amazing the way she could play the violin. It made it hard for people to believe that she was only 10. But behind every brilliant mind there lies a monster. This one just so happened to be her father. So that he was sick, he'd get a rush by playing touchy-touchy, telling her to keep it hush. This was a secret way of love, and that he needed someone he could trust. Fucked her head up, saying if mama was alive, she'd be so proud of us. So she hide her desire to die. But if you pay close attention, you can see the sorrow in her eyes. Walking around in the only real hell, no one would ever think she'd have such a story to tell. Afraid to go home, afraid to talk, afraid to cry. She was too young to even know why. And every day she'd go to the river with a message in a bottle, saying, please God help me, I don't wanna live to see tomorrow. Strange, it's time for a tiny shred of hope, just to wish the bottle would stay afloat. But every single silence every day, the bottle seems to sink. I don't know why, but the bottle always sinks. She never sees it happen, but the bottle always sinks. Now only the bottom of the river knows what she really thinks. She made that violin sing with so much pain, you could almost hear it scream through the strange vibration. What was once sweet and innocent is now rotting, cause the psychotic father chose to grow the flowers of the pure and sacred. Her instrument was her only tongue to express the infinite abuse in its depths. At night the footsteps crept to her door, and she began to shake and weep. And with tears rolling down her cheeks, she pretend she was asleep. When the nightmare was over and the sun dawned its light, she retreat to the same place she always did. Rip a page from her diary and write with all her might, and send it off into the current, determined to find a destination.
Go to the river with a message in a bottle, saying, please God help me, I don't wanna live to see tomorrow.
Strange, it's time for a tiny shred of hope, just to wish the bottle would stay afloat. But every single silence every day, the bottle seems to sink. I don't know why, but the bottle always sinks. She never sees it happen, but the bottle always sinks. Now only the bottom of the river knows what she really thinks. Being a victim of her daddy's hands for so long, she lost the will to move on. Sick of picking up the violin to hide from what's wrong. Exhausted with staying strong, she tried to play the bright side, but couldn't bring herself to make nothing but sad songs. Sick of that sick feeling that stays in her stomach, sick of waiting for a rescue by someone who found one of her bottles. Sick of keeping daddy's little secret, she got up at the crack of day and smashed the violin into pieces. Then proceeded to walk towards the river with a plan. Only this time a diarrhea bottle was in her hand. Just walking herself away from the hill, not knowing that the river bottom lied. All the cries for help, it was weeks before they found a dead body. Some fishermen reeled it from the water like something from a detective novel. Diagnosis, suicide, stemmed from desperation, cause near where she drowned they found about 500 messages in sunken bottles.